Poirot murmured, "It's not quite as simple as that, my friend. Our friend the doctor here will tell you so. With gesture and book signified that there are three conductors might depart. We have still to see eight passengers," said Poirot, "five. First-class passengers, Princess Dagomirov, Count and Countess Andrei, Colonel Eppersnut, Mr. Harman, as a three second-class passenger, Miss Dibenham, Antonio Foscarelli, and the lady maid, Fräulein Schmidt. Gesture signified passenger. Poirot murmured, "It's not quite so simple as that, my friend. Our friend, the doctor, here will tell you so. With gesture and book signified that the three conductors might depart. We have still to see eight passengers," said Poirot. Five first-class passengers, Princess Dragomirov, Count and Countess Andrei, Colonel Eberthard and Mr. Harbour. Three second-class passengers, Miss Dibenham, Antonio Foscarelli and the lady maid Fräulein Schmidt. Whom will you see first?" The Italian, half sharp, "On your Italian. No, we will start with top of three them. Perhaps Madame Princess will be good as to spare a few moments of your time. Convey that message to him." "Qui, Monsignor," said the conductor, who was quietly in the car. "Tell you we can wait on her in her compartment, if she does not wish to put herself in trouble of coming here," said M. Book. "Convey message trouble. Whom will you see first, the Italian? How sharp is you on your Italian? Now we'll start at the top of the three. Perhaps Madame Miss Princess will be so good as to spare us a few moments of your time. Convey that message to her, Michael." "Qui, Monsignor," said the conductor, who was leaving the car. "I tell you we can wait on her in her compartment if she does not wish to put herself in the trouble of coming here." Репетитор по скайпу, Smart Teacher 197.